Check.
Got it finally. Okay. Please stand for the processional of the class of 2023, invocation, and the national anthem.
Thank you.
Let us pray. Dear Heavenly Father, we come to you today with full hearts and spirits of celebration. I thank you for every single person here in this building. I thank you for this class of 2023, the faculty, our loved ones, and the gracious community of Corbin. God, I thank you for getting us to this point in our lives, and I thank you for the precious blood of Jesus that was given as ransom for our iniquities. Lord, as we sit here today for the last time as a class, I pray for these next precious moments together. I pray for our speakers, and I pray for every single graduate about to cross this stage. Jesus, as we enter a new stage in our lives, please keep us under your hedge of protection and always guide our steps in accordance to your will for our lives. Lord, I pray for all the grand things you have planned for this talented group you have created. Help our families adjust to this change and prepare our hearts to accept the new challenges coming ahead. God, I pray for the times we get frightened, overwhelmed, homesick, or discouraged. I pray that we lean towards the cross in our time of success and failure and constantly aim to glorify you. God, I pray for salvation over anyone who may not know you, that they would accept the gift of Jesus into their hearts. Lastly, I just thank you, Jesus, for letting me be part of this group sitting here today, and I thank you for letting us all be Corbin Redhounds. It is in your name we pray. Amen.
Please be seated. On behalf of the Board of Education, welcome to the graduation ceremony for the Corbin High School class of 2023. Today is a momentous occasion celebrating the remarkable achievements of our graduates
and honoring their hard work, dedication, and perseverance. Thank you for joining our celebration and recognition of this exceptional class. We extend our deepest gratitude to the parents, guardians, and families who have supported our graduates throughout their educational pursuits. Your encouragement, guidance, and love have played an integral role in shaping the outstanding individuals before us today. We also want to acknowledge the tireless efforts of our exceptional faculty and staff. Their commitment to providing quality education, fostering a nurturing, safe environment, and instilling a passion for learning have been instrumental in shaping the minds and hearts of our graduates. Their dedication goes beyond the classroom, and we are grateful for them. To the graduating class, we extend our heartfelt congratulations to the class of 2023. You have reached a significant milestone, and this graduation ceremony marks the beginning of a new chapter in your lives. We believe in you, and we cannot wait to see the great things that you will achieve. Again, to all, welcome to the graduation ceremony for the CHS class of 2023.
Welcome to the 106th Annual Commencement Program. We are glad you're here to celebrate with us in each one of these students' lives and each one of you that have made an impact on their lives as well. We ask that only graduates and assigned staff be on the floor during the ceremony. It's good to look around and see everyone that wanted to be here today. I've been a part of these for 34 years now. We've handed out tickets. We've been limited to four. We've been through, obviously, the COVID, but thanks to the arena and their staff, we are able to offer this to everyone. So if there is a 12 or 20 or two that wants to be here to celebrate with you, they can be. So thank you to the arena to making this possible. Faculty, please stand. I would also like all of our support staff to stand at this time. This group of educators have gone above and beyond to prepare these students for a successful future. I have asked numerous times for them to work on weekends, after school, at night. I don't mention so many things to them all the time, and I probably don't thank them enough. But I do know because I keep late hours and I see cars down there late at night. When I was a coach, I used to always talk about X's and O's aren't really that important because it's the passion in the players, and in this case, it's the passion in the teachers that your students have that has prepared them for their future. I also want to thank the folks that in the school system we call classified staff, but I call them friends. And they are our lifeblood. Our cooks, custodians, instructional aides, mental health counselors, youth service center coordinators, our SROs, and our ladies in the office are what makes us go. Lastly, my two assistant principals and our three guidance counselors over here and our athletic director is what keeps things smooth in the office. I'm just lucky to have the opportunity to work with all of them. Please help me give them a red hand applause. Y'all may be seated, thank you. Y'all can tell as I get older, for some reason, I get more emotional. I don't know. I guess it's how you feel as things draw near your end in your future. Seniors, I do want to thank you for each of your role over the past year, actually the past 4 years, that you've given to Corbin High School. You may not know the impact now, but you will in the future as you look back and reflect on what you've accomplished and what you've done. It is my wish that you remember things like movie night that we were able to have at Campbell Field this year, hall decorating, pep rallies, cheering at games or performances from our arts departments on the stage with our theater department, being on the fields with your classmates for the multitude of activities that we have or extracurricular competitions that you go to, even bagel days that I know that you love, or the muffin days that Jay hated. The cleanup was always not his favorite day. Walking the halls, though, are now a thing of the past for you. Just as they are for me, I sat in the very seat in Gillum Gym 40 years ago this week as one of you, as a Corbin graduate. It goes by fast. I hope COVID is a distant memory to you now, as you all were our freshmen that year. And I pray that you will never, ever use it as an excuse for why you don't reach your goals in life, okay? Because from the position I sit in, I have heard it long enough that it's because of COVID. That's over. Go out and achieve your goals, okay? I appreciate the kind good mornings that you all probably think it's just it's my highlight of my day to try to make it out when something's not going on. You all probably think that I'm bugging you in the morning or something, but I try to say good morning to as many people as I can because it is the highlight of my day as things get going forward. I have to mention two here, Aaron Good and Maria Bennett. Please stand up. Can y'all kind of look around to the whole crowd? And don't do it if you're not going to show the smile that you show me all the time. I don't know what connections you have in the office or the man upstairs. But you don't know how many days you've said things to me. It's helped. Thank you. Thank you. Caring's the greatest gift. Please hang on to that. You can always get a job if you're a caring person. Beyond high academics, this class has celebrated artists, actors, musicians, vocalists, and athletes. This year's seniors are regional winners, state runner-ups in multiple sports, in academics, in bands. I think we're a state champion in band this year as well. We've had success with our arts and humanities and even our technology department with our friends down south at the ATC program and as well as our business competitions. We have a unreal amount of things to offer the students, and this group has took full advantage of that. Sitting before you also are all-state athletes, artists, instrumentalists, and choir students this year. We've had one band member that's out here that has made all-state 4 straight years, which according to Mr. Duncan has never been done before. Congratulations. We also have accomplished mechanics, welders, electricians, construction specialists now with our new program, HVAC technicians, and future military leaders. As you can see, if you can't find something, you're not looking very hard at Corbin High School. Congratulations to all your achievements, seniors, and your hard work. We recently celebrated Awards Day, Their academic and extracurricular efforts have garnered them over $4 million in scholarships this year. These scholarships are for either two-year or four-year programs. At this time, I would like to recognize and ask them to stand up Joseph Horbath, that is attending the University of Louisville. Landon Sizemore, that is attending Somerset Community College. McKenna Severe, that is attending the University of Cumberland. And Kaylee Bullard, that is attending the University of Cumberland. They probably don't have any idea why I'm asking them to stand up because of the great support that we receive here at Corbin High School. I had someone call me two nights ago and offer four scholarships. You all are going to be receiving $2,500 each. These are in memory of Mr. Vernon Calhoun and Mr. Bob Daniels. This person wanted to do something for this year's graduating class in their honor. If you don't know these folks, if you're an old folk person like me, then you remember Daniels Department Store that was here many years and one of our bankers here in town. And the other Vernon Calhoun, was an instructional assistant here at Corbin School System back in the 70s and the 80s. But an anonymous donor just called me out of the blue, and you all were selected. Congratulations. This group sitting before you has accumulated over 2,000 hours of dual credit classes towards higher education. For you as parents, that means money saved, to say the least. 90% of this group is either college ready, career ready, or college and career ready. We have seven juniors, I think it's the most ever, am I correct? That have applied for the state's early graduation program sitting amongst us today. They have fulfilled all of the state's requirements and they are graduating 1 year early. Congratulations on this accomplishment. Each year we try to highlight a few unique stories. So at this time, I would like Abriella Sizemore, Nathaniel Lawson, and Titus Arnold to please stand. I think we need to thank these folks for their selfless sacrifice of enlisting in the military. Thank you all. As many of you, I always, I've been raised to go to college, and I thought college was the way to go. But we've discovered many times now, especially in the position after I moved down to a principal, there's so many things out there. And our school obviously demonstrated it again this year by opening an HVAC and construction center. We have two students among us that have the opportunity to go this next year, gain real-world experience, work side-by-side with technicians, take college entry classes, and earn a potential $80,000 while doing it. I dare say that there's many people in the stands would like to earn $80,000 while getting an education, while learning side-by-side somebody that has experience in everything through the Boyd Cat Thinking Big program. Please, Jacob Henson and Troy Faulkner, stand. Congratulations, gentlemen, and thank you to our ATC friends. Lastly, we have one more student that I want to recognize. And I've been around Corbin a long time, obviously. I say that a lot. You do that when you get older. This student has won 2 state titles while he's here. He has 2 state runner-ups. He has a 3rd place finish. 7 regional titles. He travels 50 miles a day to come to Corbin. You all may not know that. According to the ATC, he does excellent electrical work. Please stand, John Hale. Keep standing, John Hale. I want everybody to see this, gentlemen, because I don't know if you'll see it again with all the things I read out. Yes, there's people that have a few titles. They have this. But this student has never missed a day of school in 12 years on top of that. Congratulations. Some last thoughts for you, the class of 23. And I promise I'm not trying to get deep, but anybody knows me, that's kind of how I am. Don't run from failure. Embrace it. Today is about successes, but I want to remind you that failure is okay because it molds you for your future. Many of you have come into my office this year, I would say 20 plus. And the common phrase that I hear so many times is, what if? What if? What if? I say, what if you don't take the hard road? What if you don't seek the hardest challenges that are before you? What if you're age 50 and you discover your best really wasn't your best? So the last 25 years, you've only given half. I know that could be a scary thought, but I'm trying to challenge you because I see great potential before me. You have only one day today. Yesterday, you can't go back and fix. So every day needs to be your best effort. It can only be written once. I say these things because I care about your future. I care about my future. I had a talk with y'all about a month ago, and I truly believe you all are future. You're my future. You're their future. That could be heavy thought, but it's exciting too, of what things can be standing before us right now. In closing, do not be strangers. Come visit us often. When given the opportunity, speak and act proudly to be Corbin graduates. It is a very special place. You discover that year after year that you're not with us. If time permits, come back and serve in our community. We need you. If not here, serve in your communities that you are in the future. It has been my honor to serve you.
Thank you.
Everyone, teachers, family, friends, and graduates, here we are.
My name is Rochelle Gilbert, and I am the senior class secretary of the Biomed Club. I say that because that is the only election that I ran for this year and didn't lose. All jokes aside, to some of you, I'm just an acquaintance or a school friend. My teacher's a former student, my coach's a former athlete, and to some of you, a former teammate. But to others of you, more importantly, I'm a sister in Christ, and the title that is my most prized possession is that I'm a child of God. I'm honored and pleased to be standing before you all today. To those of us that are the graduating class of 2023, look at us. From walking into high school as freshmen and having our first year cut short, here we are. We made it. From essentially doing our whole sophomore year online and having to make accommodations to all of our extracurricular activities, to starting our junior year in masks, never thinking we would survive AP US history, and everything that junior year had to throw at us, here we are. We made it. I'll never forget walking into high school on the first day of freshman year and seeing students that looked like full-grown men with full-face beards and were 10 feet tall. No kidding, the scariest and most unexpected experience of my life. I'll never forget those teachers who always seemed to have the worst coffee breath whenever we raised our hands and needed help with something. I'll never forget the pig dissection smell of the classroom during our senior year. Shout out to my biomed class, you know what I'm talking about. I'll never forget ABC breakfast and eating those awesome, delicious fried apples. Shout out to our lunch ladies. I'll never forget that one teacher that we all have, letting us come to them with all of our problems and tell them how hard life is as a full-time high school student. Shout out to you guys too. I'll never forget dancing with all the science teachers in the science wing hallway. We could really bust a move. Finally, I'll never forget cheering under the lights and hearing the traditional, "That's another red hound, first down." Oh, the little things of high school. Last but not least, I'll never forget you guys, the senior class. We've grown up together and seen each other at so many different stages of life. I repeat, we've grown up. Here we are. We've made it. That leads us to this year, our senior year. When they tell you that the 4 years of high school fly by, they aren't kidding. Senior year can be stressful and chaotic, especially with all the festivities that have led us here today, the Corbin Arena on May 27th, 2023. We will walk out of these doors and some of us will never see each other again. We're about to go our separate ways and create a new life for ourselves. We're stepping into the big world. The scary thing is, we're on our own now. The cool thing is, we're on our own now. We've already made a huge life decision on how we want to further our education at a university or college level, trade school, or have already chosen a career path. This is just one of the many substantial choices we will have to make in our lives that affect the rest of our lives moving forward. Let's never forget, we serve a sovereign God, yet we can decide who we want to be. We have the freedom to direct our life in whatever direction we desire, though, we should strive to serve God and each other humbly with this privilege that we have been given through God's grace. High school has taught us a plethora of things, and this next season of life will teach us so much more. I encourage you to never stop learning. As Sir Francis Bacon said, knowledge itself is power. Throughout life and high school, I have learned valuable lessons that I believe could be an encouragement to each of us today. Number one, we should be kind. Our kindness has a kind of elegance, and you never know what sincere gesture might just make someone's day. Our kindness should be genuine and with good intentions, and it really shows the character of someone's heart. Number two, we should put our best efforts into whatever we pursue. We should be diligent, work hard, and perform to the best of our abilities that God has given us. Lastly, number three, seize your moment. Whatever it might be that presents itself in your path, pray about it and take advantage of the opportunity given to you. That is why I want to seize my moment right now with the opportunity I've been given to speak to you all today. Anyone who knows me knows that I am passionate about the gospel, and I'd like to tell you all a story that most definitely applies to a day like today. You've probably heard of this story before. The truth is, in the beginning was the Word, and when the Word was with God, and the Word was God. God created the heavens and the earth and everything in between. He created Adam, and then he created Eve, woman for man. Because of Eve's disobedience to God, sin entered the world, which is why tragedy and bad things happen today in our broken world. God sent his one and only son, Jesus, to live a perfect life and be the perfect sacrifice to atone for all of our sins. The barrier between God and us was broken. Not only that, but he rose again 3 days later. He defeated death and ascended into heaven. Jesus left the Holy Spirit with us to have once we've accepted the free gift of God and use it to live in those who believe in him. Romans 6:23 says, "For the wages of sin is death, but the gift of God is eternal life in Christ Jesus our Lord." And for my Guadalajara team, in Spanish, "Porque la paga del pecado es muerte, mas la dádiva de Dios es vida eterna en Cristo Jesús Señor nuestro." Either way you say it, it means the same. We get to have a personal relationship with the God who saves and a God that is so authentically good. Following in the worldly things only gives us death, but the free gift of God gives us eternal life in heaven with the creator of the universe. One of my favorite verses is Luke 12:27-28. It says, "Consider how the wildflowers grow. They do not labor or spin. Yet I tell you, not even Solomon in all his splendor was dressed like one of these. If that is how God clothes the grass of the field, which is here today, and tomorrow is thrown into the fire, how much more will he clothe you, you of little faith?" Going into this next stage of life, we should be reminded to consider the wildflowers, how much more the Father will provide for us, and how comforting it is that he is our best friend. I have complete confidence that my God is our protector, conqueror, and has the most precise and perfect planner of all time. We should trust this and embrace this, because as the song goes, even when I don't see it, you're working. Even when I don't feel it, you're working. There are going to be times in our life when we feel like we're not enough or we're too much, where we underreact and overreact, times we experience an ultimate loss, times we experience an ultimate W. We will overthink, not think enough, create a false reality where only our personal experience exists, deny ever messing up, feel very guilty, feel overwhelmed, ruin perfectly fine relationships, self-sabotage, become ill and green with envy, be filled with pride, and just can't seem to shake the things we've done in the past. Times we feel the need to fight back, and times we want to run, hide. Times of empowerment and confidence. We will experience extreme happiness and very high highs. We'll feel on top of the world, number one on the podium, and like we're winning the race. I know our class, and I know there will be times where we will become competitive and do anything to come out first in whatever we pursue, annihilate anything that gets in our way of what we view as success. We will lose things, which probably means that we will gain things too. Congrats, we are all human. All of this proves that the story of Adam and Eve is true. We have a sinful nature and live on this earth as sinful humans who will go through sinful experiences. I say this because the world will knock us down, as scripture says that we will all face obstacles and trials. The Bible is a big love story of God's love for us. The Bible is the truth, and we can look to the Bible for all of life's answers and guidance. I encourage each of you to pick it up. Pick it up and use it. It is our sword and our armor of God. And if you think that you've already messed up too much to accept salvation, or if you have to be a certain kind of person to be a servant of God, that cannot be further from the truth. God doesn't call the equipped to join his army. He equips the called. As I mentioned earlier, we all have the freedom to choose who we want to be. We are all born with a God-sized hole in our heart, but we all have the freedom to be one of the called and fill that hole once we admit that we are a sinner in need of a Savior, repent of our sins, fully surrender and place our trust in Jesus Christ, and live a life of obedience and action. Because when we're knocked down, whether we realize it or not, we're on our backs looking up to God. He is truly the only way that we can be upright on our feet, take his hand, and walk on the right path. Let's know God and make him known. The Alpha and the Omega, Yahweh, Adonai, the I Am, the way, the truth, and the life. That's what I'm holding on to when I leave here today, when I wake up tomorrow, and as I live the rest of my life. I'm filled with a strength and joy that only comes from him as I stand before all of you today. My fellow graduates, I love you all. I hope to see you all, and I mean in the sweetest way possible, at the local Mexican when we come back into town for holidays and breaks. You each mean so much to me, and I appreciate how each of you have helped shape me into the person I am today. Each of you are going to do amazing things, and I hope you never lose sight of your worth. You each are made a masterpiece in God's image. Remember who you are representing. remember whose you are. Remember our bond with each other, one that is so unbreakable. Remember that we, as Wendy says, have a whole lot of history. I'm so excited for each of our next steps after our big graduation day. I pray the biggest blessings upon each of you. Again, don't forget to be kind, put your best foot forward, and seize your moment. Congratulations, class of 2023. Here we are. All glory to God. Thank you, and God bless.
Greetings, fellow graduates, family, staff, and alumni. My name is Olivia Jones, and when reflecting upon my high school experience, I decided that Charles Dickens described it perfectly. It was the best of times, and it was the worst of times. I mean, we entered high school bottle flipping, playing Fortnite, and dancing to Renegade thinking we were cool. We cheered through the Friday night lights, joined clubs, went on field trips, napped during class, and most impressively, learned how to write a 10-page paper the night before it was due. We owe a huge thanks to Quizlet and SparkNotes, but we made it. All of our work, procrastination, and questionable decisions along the way have led us to this very moment. This is it. We are here together one last time, the class of 2023. I know we are all feeling a complex range of emotions today. Some of you may be excited and fill with anticipation for what comes next. Others may be feeling that sad sentiment of leaving our childhood behind, or nervous that the future is now approaching. I know that I am feeling a mixture of all of this. But the fact is, we are entering a complex, dynamic, and unpredictable world where we have yet to experience our greatest moments of triumph, and with that, great moments of defeat. Whether you are attending university, trade school, the military, the workforce, or following your own dream, you want independence. You want stability. You want an opportunity. You want your shot. There is an overwhelming pressure for us to have an exact plan and to quickly transition into adulthood. That is scary to say the least. It seems like only yesterday we were just kids in high school. It was literally just yesterday, guys. It feels like we are being taken by a huge tide and carried out to sea, where we must learn to keep our head above water on our own. But I want you to hit the pause button. Forget about your anxieties, forget about your plans, and forget about this pressure to succeed. Ask yourself this very important question. Who are you going to be? Notice I am not asking what you are going to do, though this is the question we have been asked our whole senior year. I am asking what kind of person you want to be and how you are going to choose to live your life each day. The reality is, we are not remembered by our grades or popularity, extracurriculars, or how many likes we got on Instagram, even though these are the things that seem the most important now. Instead, we are remembered by the relationships we make. We are remembered by the lives we touch and the people we inspire. I am challenging you to think beyond your own agenda and your checklist of things to do in order to be successful. Focus more on what kind of person you want to be to other people. The difference you make in the lives of others is more important than money, status, or recognition. We are entering a time in our lives where we will feel anxious, alone, or unsure about our future. There is no script from here on out. That is why it is important now more than ever to practice empathy and understanding, to be a friend and solace, and to empower others and ourselves to be unafraid of struggles and focused on the good ahead. If you can have this impact on other people, you will be successful. One of my favorite quotes is from Shakespeare. It states, "Some are born great, some achieve greatness, and some have greatness thrust upon them." We cannot count on being born great or having greatness thrust upon us, but we can pursue and achieve greatness. Do not let others tell you what your success and happiness should look like. That is a decision completely unique and special to you. I am challenging you to worry less about expectations, less about having the answers, and less about what you are going to do with your life. Do not bother to be better than your predecessors or contemporaries. Success is thriving to be better than yourself. It is waking up and deciding to be a better person than you were yesterday. Success is grasping the awareness that you are enough. Success is a continuous journey of finding who you are and what you can do to better our world and your own life. Success is a sense of satisfaction with the person you have become through achievements you earn and hardships you learn from. But most importantly, success is being the best version of yourself and leading by example while inspiring others to be their best too. It will require hard work and sacrifice and the choice to get back up every time life knocks you down. But I believe that each and every one of us has the potential to make a difference in the world and change lives if we wish to. Miss Perry would not approve if I said in conclusion here, so I have one final remark. I call all of you to think less of all the things you have to do to achieve success. Rather, think about who you need to be. Strive not to be a woman or man of success, but a person of value to yourself and others. Look around at our world and how lucky we are to be alive right now. Take control of your life and do with it what you want. Love who you are, love what you do, and love the way you do it. Rise up and take every opportunity to better yourself and have an impact on the people in your life. The future is yours, but who will tell your story? Thank you.
Thank you. I looked over at Stephanie, and she had this look on her face. She thought I was leaving. Not just yet. I'm Dave Cox. I'm superintendent of Corbin Independent Schools. I'm very proud to be here. It's going to be redundant, a few of the things that I say. I'm going to welcome everyone, certainly. You've been welcomed by almost every speaker thus far. And I also want to tell you I've got some thanks, though. There's a lot of folks to thank, and I've got a very quick list, and I'll do my best to be as brief as I can. But there's some people that will be thanked, obviously, that have already been thanked, but they probably deserve more than one thanks. First of all, let me start with Ms. Jill Lewis. Jill, would you stand up, please, back in the back? I see you in your familiar place. Wave to everybody, please, Ms. Lewis. Ms. Lewis has orchestrated this event for several years. For those of you who are just here for the first time, Ms. Lewis has done this for a number of years. And she always seems to make things go seamlessly. It's very professional, it's very caring, and very intimate. And we certainly owe a lot of thanks to her. She also takes care of all the duties of the baccalaureate, and she's done so flawlessly for many, many years. I'm going to go off script a bit and ask my friend Landon Sizemore to step up here and help me with something real quickly. Ms. Lewis, if you would, please meet Landon in the middle of the graduates, if you will. We've got a small token of our appreciation, and please join me in thanking Ms. Lewis for all she's done for these many years. Thank you, Landon, and thank you, Ms. Lewis. I knew that I couldn't get Jill to come up on the stage, so I thought possibly I could get her to meet us halfway. Thank you very much. Another duty that Ms. Lewis has assigned to me is welcoming you, as I said, and on behalf of the Board of Education, I do that, and it occurred to me while I was thinking that it's quite possible that many of the folks in the audience, or even the graduates, don't know who our Board of Education is. Would all of our board members stand, please, that are here today? Join me in thanking them. Thank you. These folks work tirelessly. They work many, many hours more than just board meetings, and with as much construction and things that we've been doing in the past couple of years, they've had to put in a lot of hours. Certainly, they're unsung heroes behind the scenes, and we appreciate all that they do. It also occurred to me that since they're my boss, I had never introduced them at graduation before. I thought maybe I should do that too. So thank them. Thank you very much for being here and doing all that you do. Next. I'd like to thank Mark Daniels and his staff. I'm not sure where Mark's at. He's probably behind the scenes, as he usually is, making sure that all the sound and all the video and everything works as well as they do. We also have with us today Mr. Brad Jones on loan from Laurel County. In case you didn't know it, there's three graduations going on in this facility today. South Laurel and North Laurel will be following us, so we decided to combine sound systems, and we appreciate Laurel County loaning us their folks. We're certainly very thankful. Join me in thanking Mark, rather, and Mr. Jones. Whether it's a baccalaureate or it is graduation, Ms. Lewis makes out the itinerary, as I told you earlier, and she either has me always following the choir or following the band. And that's a tough act to follow, let me tell you, because both of those groups are incredibly talented, and they add a lot to everything that they do. So let's thank the band today for being here as well. In addition to this graduation, Mr. Duncan also had five of his members attend our School of Innovation graduation and added a really nice touch to that gathering as well. So thank you all very much. Lastly, but certainly not least, I want to thank the teaching staff of our district from preschool through high school who are simply magnificent at their job. Also, a huge thanks to our classified staff, bus drivers, cafeteria workers, custodians, technology folks, instructional assistants, and everybody that has helped you reach this point in your career. Probably the most unsung heroes in our school district, though, and I believe this because I know a little bit about that job, are the principals and assistant principals in your buildings. Those folks work countless hours. They're there when you get there, there before you get there. They're always there after you leave. They're managing all of their staff. They're doing such a wonderful job to keep you guys where you're at right now and to keep our district where it's at. Please join me in thanking all those folks as well. I get to do a lot of fun stuff up here because thanking the folks is something that I need to do more often. I'm like Mr. Jewell. We try to be a little more cognizant of that, but a lot of times we let it slip by. I'd like to ask one last favor of the graduating class, and you can think about this. When you go through the line today, you're going to get your diploma, and you're also going to get a challenge coin. This is a gift from the district to you, and the meaning behind the challenge coin is to recognize a significant achievement or to recognize a particular group that you're joining. The group you're joining today is the Red Hound family. It's a pretty big group, a bunch of folks everywhere. And if we could put dots on a map as to where all the successful people are in the United States that are part of this Red Hound family, it would be a solid dot. We're everywhere. The Red Hound folks are everywhere. Now you're part of that family. You're going to be very soon here. And I want you to think about this challenge coin, and this is the challenge that comes along with that. That challenge is this. There's a lot of folks that helped you get to where you're at today. My guess is those very same folks are going to help you get to where you're at tomorrow, next week, next year, and on down the road. Take the time to thank these people. And I would ask this. Take the time to write them a personal note. Not a text, not an email, not a Snapchat, not an Instagram, whatever it is that is out there now. Write a personal note. If you can hand it to them, that's even better. If you can't, put it in the mail, the snail mail. It'll get to them eventually. You'll find that note somewhere down the road. It will be folded up in a Bible. It will be in their personal belongings. It might even get plastered on the refrigerator. But I've shared this message and this request for a number of years now, and I've had so many people come up to me and say, thank you for doing that because that's the first note my child ever wrote me or my grandchild or whoever that may be. So please think about that. It would make you feel good. I know that. But it's going to make them feel even better. So if you could do that for us, we'd certainly appreciate it. Take this coin and remember this day and remember your career at Corbin. Thank you very much.
Graduating class, please stand. Superintendent Cox, I present the graduating class of 2023. They have fulfilled all requirements for the State Board of Education, the Corbin Board of Education, and Corbin High School. They are eligible to receive their diplomas.
Thank you, Mr. Jewell. On behalf of the Board of Education and State Board of Education, I accept your presentation of this class, and because they have completed all requirements, they may receive their diplomas.
Class, please be seated. Mrs. Nancy Wyatt, Ms. Stephanie Pennington, Mrs. Jamie Cutshaw, our guidance counselors, will call the roll.
We are actually doing something different this year.
We are going to record our students for our Distinguished with Highest Honors. So if you see them stop behind me, that's because they are receiving another award for accomplishment.
Amanda
Paige Havers. Angelina Rochelle Rose Gilbert, the senior for college honors. Olivia Marie Jones, distinguished at Kaya Simon. Grace Ellen Gibson, distinguished with highest honors. Jaden Christopher Alford, distinguished with high honors. Gloria Avelina Anderson. Emmeline Kate Olivia Ashley, distinguished with Kai Sonner. Jacob William Baker. Caitlin Elise Ball, distinguished with Kai Sonner. America Michelle Barajas. Brendan Barajas. Elizabeth Madison Barker, distinguished retirement. Maria Bonnie Ellen Bennett. Savannah Lynn Blankenship. Kaylin McKenzie Ledsoe, distinguished for high honors. Jacob Connor Ball. Sophie May Boggs, high honors. Trinity J. Holster, high honors.
Eli Jared Bolton. Taryn Elena Brewer. Jeremiah Broughton. Caleb David Donahue Brown. Joshua Sean Brummett. Kaylee Hannah Bullard. Distinguished with high honors. Mackenzie May Bunch. Caitlin Maritzia Bussier. Gary Obert Kaplinger. Ashton Langley Carter, high honors. Kaylee Elizabeth Carter. Maxwell Douglas Cathers. Riley Claire Childers, distinguished with highest honors. Brianna Lynn Childress, distinguished with high honors. Aiden Vaughn Sima. Gabriel Paul Sima, distinguished with highest honors. McCaden Jean Collins. Brendan Dwayne Combs. Cameron James Combs. Taylor Michelle Cottingham. Tanner Ray Davis, distinguished with highest honors. Sydney Madison Dixon. Tristan Cheyenne Donnell. Kaylee Renee Farmer, distinguished with highest honors. Samuel Grant Farmer, distinguished with high honors. Brandon Troy Faulkner. Bailey Lynn Feltner. Jarrett Tyler Fields. Gabriel James Fisher. Elijah Pierce Fortney, high honors. Cameron Jayana Frazier. Lucas Reed Frederick. Alexandra Morgan Freeman, distinguished with highest honors. Haley Marie George Alderman, high honors. Noah Bryce Giles, distinguished with highest honors. Serenity Jade Getz. Aaron Alexis Good, high honors.
Dalton Connor Grega, distinguished with highest honors. Jason Hunter Griffin. Braden D. Grubb. Madison Ray Geyer. Liam James Guy. Macy Faith Hagen, distinguished with highest honors. John Robert Hell. Aaron Jacob Hall. Hunter Lee Hamlin. Zane Ryan Hammock. H. Gray Hawkins, distinguished with high honors. Noah Landon Henry. Jacob Nathaniel Henson. Landon Xavier Hildebrand. Allie Reagan Hill. And Marie Caroline Hill, high honors. Wyatt Lane Thomas Horton. Joseph Ray Horvath, distinguished with highest honors. Lucas Ray Hubbard. James Cody Wayne Hubbs. Ian Harrison Jackson. Jeremiah Gavin Jackson. Lindsay Lee Renee Jackson. Mary Hope Jackson, high honors. Nathaniel Kyle Jackson. Camden Cole Johnson. Lane Parker Johnson. Chance Johnson Kaufman. Abriella Lynn Jones. Cheyenne Oceana Jones. Jade Renee Jones, distinguished with highest honors. Peyton Andrew Jordan. Candace Lily Keith. Jason Paul Killian, distinguished with highest honors. Keaton Reed Killian. Brady Thomas Lanham. Ethan Russell Lawson. Fisher Keaton Lawson. Madison Riley Lawson. Nathaniel Douglas Lawson. Elijah Jackson Lay. Emmy Rose Lewis, high honors. Chloe Faith Licklider. Alexis Lachey Littrell. Hayden Josiah Llewellyn. Alexis Shakira Lockard, high honors. Kenton Thomas Lowe, distinguished with highest honors. Allison Paige Lundy, distinguished with highest honors. Abigail Rose Lunsford, high honors. Gabriel Patrick Mahan, high honors. Titus Andrew Mahan. Solera Elise Marlowe. Alex Olivia Martinez. Jonathan Tayton McCauley. Barton Craig McDaniel.
Ashley Nicole McIntyre. Sharla Janelle McKitty, distinguished with highest honors. Olivia Johnny Elaine McQueen. Michael Mowry. Anthony Thomas Myers. Benjamin Paul Minot. Rachel Emma Jean Newberry. Parker Allen Norville. Austin Edward Uten, high honors. Lauren Paige Osborne. Connor Allen Overbay, high honors. Jacob Dean Owens, distinguished with high honors. Nate Holden Owens, high honors. John Gabriel Palake. Harsh Pankaj Patel. Sheil Lalbai Patel, distinguished with highest honors. Nikhil Malhotra Patil, distinguished with high honors. Joaquin Santiago Cabral Powig, distinguished with highest honors. Joshua Pellegrini. Autumn Melody Perkins. Buddy James Perkins. Elizabeth Grace Phipps, high honors. Mackenzie Ashlyn Powell. Summer Jean Powers. Seamus Reese Ragsdale. Gage Timothy Joe Ramsey. Terrell Keith Ramsey. Scout Denise Reams. Elena Danielle Reynolds. Kenneth Amon Root. McKenna Kate Severe, distinguished with high honors. Riley Camille Sexton. Kalia Sims. Landon Scott Sizemore. Abigail Grace Skeen, distinguished with high honors. Davy Leanne Smith. Suede Tyler Smith. Hagen Ronald Steele. Seth Thomas Steely, high honors. Kobe Ty Stevens, distinguished with highest honors. Brianna Faith Destiny Stewart. Courtney Stewart. Jaden Ray Storm. Israel Summers. Melissa Deyanira Torres. Sully Tony. Kaden Marie Walden, distinguished with highest honors. Taylor Ryan Waldo. Billy Dottie Warren. Mark Alvis Warren. Ryan Patrick Warren. Brody Glenn Wells. Caitlin Christina Will, distinguished with highest honors. Emma Elizabeth Williams. Josie Lee Williams. David Wyatt. Cadence McKinley Wynn, distinguished with highest honors.
Apparently, I don't read the script very well. Ms. Lewis is going to be upset with me. There's some groups we're going to recognize as soon as everybody gets set here that I overlooked. Two groups real quickly. Okay, first of all, with the seniors graduating with honors, please stand. Congratulations. Seniors graduating with high honors, please stand. Thank you. Now, seniors with highest honors, please stand. Thank you. I suppose when you put in that much work, it doesn't hurt to be recognized twice. So congratulations to all of you. Also, there are five seniors with perfect attendance for all 4 years of high school. Would you please stand? And would you please sit, except for John Hale? Again, redundant, but thank you, Mr. Hale. John Hale is, to repeat what was said earlier, John has had perfect attendance his entire career at Corbin Independent Schools. Thank you. I had the opportunity to meet John just a couple days ago. Officer Greg Hill and I were doing some work down at the high school, and John came up and started talking to us, and Officer Hill informed me that John had not missed a day of school since he'd been in school. And I said, wow, that is a great accomplishment. And I recently heard a quote that somebody said, the best ability in life is availability. And so I shared that quote with John, and John looked me right in the eye and he said, you've got to go to work, which is what I expect he'll do. So thank you very much.
Everyone, please stand. Let us pray. Dear God, thank you so much for this beautiful day. Thank you for each graduate in this room right now and the hand of protection you've placed on each of them. I pray as we go out and begin this new chapter of our lives, you continue to lead and guide each of us as aligns to your will. Fill us with strength to get through the hard times and a heart of love for you and for others. God, above all, thank you for your son, Jesus, for sending him down to this earth as a man to live the perfect life that none of us could, then to pay the price that we couldn't pay for our sins by being crucified on the cross, but raising again 3 days later. Lord, I pray for anyone in this room who doesn't know you, that they would put their faith in you at this moment, because we never know when it'll be our last. Lord, I also pray right now that if anyone here is struggling to find their worth or doesn't feel loved or cared for, that you surround them with your presence. Let them know that they are deeply adored by the Creator of the universe. Your word says that you will never leave nor forsake us, and we can be filled with an overwhelming sense of peace because of that promise. In Jesus' name, amen.
Graduates, please don't forget to pick up your diploma packets on your way out. I have been asked to remind everyone that there is a graduation ceremony following this graduation ceremony as well, so please don't linger as much as possible. Graduates, you may now move your tassel to the graduated position. Ladies and gentlemen, I present you the class of 2023.